Hey guys, so we're down here with our new Honda Talon, the 1000R, a little bit wider one. We're down here at TurboLab with Joe Sims, the master turbo guy here. We want to make the shit go faster. That's what we do. Seriously, really good. So we're going to hook it up on the dyno today and see where the baseline is for just, you know, normal power. And then Honda was gracious enough to leave us a giant space behind the motor for a turbo. I think they were kind of planning.
Put as many as you want.
Right? Right. Two turbos?
That's right. Three? Four? Three. Plenty of room. Plenty
of room. We'll start with one maybe and see what happens. But
sounds good. As much room as you want.
And the main goal with the turbo kit, because I don't really want a project vehicle. We want stuff that's like reliable, play, easy, reliable, right? Pump gas. Like, and of course, you can always go crazy after that, but.
Absolutely. Yeah, you know, you want to, especially. You know, when you've got a newer, you know, a newer machine, there's a lot of prototyping you have to do and find out where the limits are. So that takes a little bit of time, but we'll start off, you know, when we build a kit, it'll have plenty of room, but we'll start off low power. Let's see where it goes from there.
That's perfect. We were at the dunes yesterday and we were not climbing huge bowls, but, you know, smaller, it was fun. It was fun. And the 104 horsepower that it supposedly has at the crane was surprisingly adequate. So another 20, 30, 40, 50 on
at
there.
Least.
It's going to be...
At least.
It's going to be super fun. So, yeah, we'll see how this goes.
Yeah.
Cross the little train.
Yeah,
maybe.
If this doesn't work, let's put on a four-wheel drive. The only problem is you're really going to get a skewed number on the four-wheel drive because the four-wheel drive is going to suck out a lot.
Yeah.
we can make one. I'm gonna do one more right now.
Okay.
For back.
Okay.
Back to two wheel drive.
Back to two wheel drive.
Same thing again. Yeah. Okay, cool.
your best number to date, actually.
How is dynoing?
Dude, that's pretty cool. That's really cool.
Yeah, 60 foot-pounds of torque, 73 horsepower.
Sweet.
Yeah, it's a good number.
Even four-wheel drive.
And four-wheel drive. And
if you look at the two numbers, those are both our four-wheel drive runs. See how close they are?
Yeah.
I mean, there's almost zero deviation.
Right at four-wheel drive. Right at four-wheel drive. You're actually getting more horsepower.
That's right. More horsepower of the tire, anyway. All
right. Okay, so we're back. So we just did the dyno run on the Talon R. We had to switch from a two-wheel drive dyno to a four-wheel drive dyno because the machine it wouldn't shift.
Yeah, it did. When it some we've had some vehicles where if it doesn't see wheel speed on the front, it won't shift or throws other faults. So this thing's pretty smart that it knew the front wheels weren't spinning. But luckily.
I hope the reliability keeps up with the smartness of it, because that kind of stuff makes me nervous on these things.
Sure.
But yeah, luckily, Joe, you have a four-wheel drive dyno also at your shop, which is pretty badass.
Convenient, yeah.
So the next big surprise were the numbers. So the four-wheel drive dyno, it drags quite a bit more power,
it
right?
It does, yeah. Well, instead of spinning, you know, one drum, you're spinning two, and you have the additional drivetrain losses of the tires and things. So you always expect four-wheel drive dynos to be slightly lower. You could guesstimate on numbers, but on this machine, I would guess we're probably anywhere from 6 to 10% lower than we should be because we have to run four-wheel drive.
Okay.
Every vehicle is a little different. It's hard to get actual numbers up. Maybe at some point Honda will release a dyno mode that allows to do two-wheel drive.
So it would really be, because I'm sure they love people messing with their stuff.
You never know. But what we'll actually do, we'll actually be able to do another vehicle that we can put two-wheel drive, and then we can bring it over here and tell exactly what the drivetrain loss is, so then we can get the exact number from this.
That will be cool.
Yep.
That will be cool, so we'll have a better range on exactly what that number should be.
Yeah, for sure.
Having said that, so on the four-wheel drive dyno, you can still run it in two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive,
correct,
the car.
Correct.
And we did both. We did a few pulls on both. And surprisingly, we saw a horsepower gain running it in four-wheel drive.
Yeah, which is unusual. I actually have never seen that before. So on the dyno graph, it picked up a solid 5 horse, and it did it across the entire band, which was surprising. Right?
Yeah. Totally bizarre.
Yeah, I've not seen that.
So we got, what did we get? About 73 horsepower.
Right at 73.
And how much on the torque again?
About 60, I think.
So not bad. Again, if we were running on a two-wheel drive dyno, we'd probably see between, 6 to 10 horsepower more than that, probably.
I would guess, yeah.
So, but for the machine, you also weighed it, and it weighed in at,
15, 20, I think, with whatever fuel load you have.
There's about a half a tank of gas in there.
Yeah.
So, and no other parts on there. Yeah. We'll get our mud flaps, but that's, 10 pounds.
55 pounds.
55 pounds. Actually, there could be 2 gallons of sand in there, because we did go to the dunes yesterday.
Yeah,
so.
Sure.
But light
very
energy.
Light.
So,
power. I think I even have a photo of it. But yeah, it was surprising how light it was. We see these kind of all over the chart from what they claim.
Yeah.
There's the actual number there.
1530.
That's a good place to start from.
Yep.
That's a good place to start from. So, that's the dyno from there. We're gonna leave this thing with Joe and let him play around with some turbo stuff and see if we can make some more power out of it.
Overall, it was good. I mean, it was better than expected.
So what are some of your thoughts? Because you do desert racing. Mm-hmm. You've got a couple of big, real buggies.
Class 1, class 10, and things
so
like that.
With that experience and that knowledge, what are some of your, just initial, looking at the machine impressions?
Well, I can tell you that this should be every bit as fast as a class 10 as far as power to weight, because those make about 140 horse, which all sounds fine and good, but at 2,800 pounds, So it should be very competitive. The weight makes a huge difference, and anybody will tell you they'd rather lose weight than gain power.
Sure.
So I think that with the power adders that we do, I think that this could be a real serious machine.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
That's exciting. All right. Well, Joe, Sim.
Yeah. That's right.
Dude,
that's
thanks
right.
for helping us out
yeah,
with this.
No problem,
and
no
we're
problem.
Excited to, we'll let you guys know what the next run is.
Stay
the next
tuned,
stage.
Yeah.
Awesome.
All right.